sweet, sweet lips, your perfect nose, your rosy cheeks, your 10 little toes, your precious little pee-pee, your wondrous eyes, your tender bottom, your pink chubby thighs.
We've waited so long for you to come. I'm your dad.
And I am your mom.
And we can see it's perfectly true. You're perfectly, perfectly you.
Welcome to BEPE Presents. Birth and Early Parenting Educators is an alliance of professionals interested in and focused on the first period of human development from conception to birth and breastfeeding. This is a dramatically important aspect of human development, perhaps the most important time for human beings in their development. And this is because we've learned recently that the baby in the womb is extraordinarily sensitive and vulnerable and open and communicative, as we were never able to know before. And we want to get the message of these new discoveries out to parents so they can benefit from them as soon as possible. This program you're about to see is one in a series of programs that we've prepared for you, which we hope will be very fascinating and illuminates this period of human development.
You're perfectly, perfectly you.
Decisions don't happen in a vacuum. Since you yourself were born, you've been influenced by your culture. You're surrounded by people with traditions and beliefs. You live in a mass media environment that competes for your attention. Your culture is full of rituals, symbols, habits, art, science, morality, commercialism, and opinions. Usually, we aren't aware of how much our culture shapes the way we make sense of the world. It might be worthwhile to examine that culture, to make it transparent, so that your values and your decisions come from you.
On TV, when women are in labor, the husbands get panicky and run around a lot. The mothers get into the hospital bed and go through a lot of pain and screaming. They ask for drugs.
I want drugs. I want massive amounts of drugs. I want the maximum legal limit of drugs.
Noted and understood.
My whole life, TV has shown me hysteria about the dire medical emergency of birth. I thought all births were like TV. I feared giving birth more than anything else I'd ever feared in my life.
This is the front line, where lives are at stake and every second counts.
Once I saw a science show on TV with this footage of a nice, normal birth. But the voiceover said, "The baby is about to begin the most dangerous journey in life, the 4-inch trip down the birth canal." Well, at least breastfeeding is getting more mainstream on TV.
Oh, God, this is weird. My body's making milk. It's like one day suddenly you find you can get bacon out of your elbow.
As you sift through your cultural environment, you'll find messages that are both terrifying and reassuring.
But then I rented that old Nova episode, Miracle of Life, and I felt so inspired. Giving birth has become less scary and even seems somehow possible.
One more in. Deep breath, quick.
Push.
Stop pushing.
Stop pushing.
There it is. Good.
Beautiful job.
Nothing's little about this baby.
Wow.
The stomach.
How you view TV and movies depends on who you are and what you've experienced.
It's just entertainment.
After seeing Miracle of Life, I am going to adopt. TV is just silly. I've seen 4 babies born in real life. I've seen 2 girls born vaginally and twin boys C-section. And I coached my best friend through a breech baby girl. I think childbirth is painful, but I would still have kids, and I'd do it naturally.
Some of my friends have watched too many of those hippie movies about giving birth in a lagoon. They feel sorry for me that I had a cesarean. Hey, I have a healthy baby, and that's what matters.
It's just TV. I can make movies too.
Hi, I'm Vicki Elson. I've been teaching childbirth education classes for 25 years. And every expectant parent comes to class with a cultural package of hopes and fears from friends, relatives, personal experience, and significantly, from the media. I've been curious about what they're watching and how it might affect their expectations and their birth experiences. So, for 15 years, I've been studying how childbirth is portrayed in hundreds of TV shows, movies, comedies, reality shows, and dramas.
Not that I expect them to have tests to identify alien life.
No, probably not.
But if they do find something unusual, maybe the FBI or NASA will listen to them. They certainly don't take phone calls from the victims of extraterrestrial insemination.
Pregnant by aliens?
It was so humiliating.
I bet.
If you're having a baby on TV or in the movies, anything can happen. You might be pregnant by aliens. You might not know you're pregnant till the baby comes out.
And I knew that it was something other than menstrual cramps.
When the baby crowned, Tanya learned the truth. Not only was she pregnant, she was giving birth.
Your mother might go nuts.
Darling, you know, some more candles in here or something. Yeah, she had a bit of aromatherapy oil, darling. Some music, sweetheart. Some drugs, medical intervention, heroin.
Natural childbirth.
Are you out of your mind?
Your water might break and cause local flooding.
My blue barb has broken. The birth spasm has begun.
You might even be a man.
Does my body disgust you?
There are 2 major reasons to broadcast birth scenes. Hollywood's reason is profit. Birth scenes are good for ratings, and how they might make pregnant women feel is incidental.
Looks like she's gonna just split in half. See, this seems barbaric. Doesn't it seem like technology would have a better way of doing this?
Allison should get a C-section.
The other reason to broadcast birth scenes is to help pregnant women feel less afraid and more confident. You'll see films with an educational agenda on PBS and in childbirth classes. And there are lots of them on YouTube. Natural childbirth documentaries tend to emphasize that the pain and the hard work can be pathways to personal satisfaction.
Oh, no, no, no,
It's okay. It's
incredible when it happens and you're by a woman's side and she comes to the end of this journey and she says, you know, I knew I couldn't do it. I knew I couldn't do it, and then I did it.
On one hand, here's how Hollywood generally deals with labor pain.
Wow, fuckity ow! Godburn, when do I get that freaking spinal tap thing?
It's called a spinal block, and you can't have it yet, honey. The doctor said you're not dilated enough.
Oh, come on! I mean, it's like, I have to wait for it to get worse? Why can't I just have the freaking thing now?
Oh, honey, doctors are sadists who like to play God and watch lesser people scream.
Ah! Oh,
shit. Excuse me, hey, can we get my kid the damn spinal tap already?
On the other hand, natural childbirth activists try to show that there's a completely different way of experiencing birth.
There was a moment that Nassim and I had where we had the sweetest, most mushy kiss, and I felt that kiss go all the way through me. And after that kiss, I felt so soft, and through each rash that I was having, I was actually purring through each, what they call contractions, but in no way did I feel contracted. I felt so expanded. And then after the purrs, like they just kept coming, and I just felt softer and softer till I just felt them coming through as rolling orgasms to the point where I was crying. I mean, it was so overwhelming, the energy. It was so, so amazing.
Many productions overemphasize either the safety or the dangers of giving birth. Here's the truth. In about 5 to 10% of human births, cesarean section is necessary for survival. For example, if the baby is stuck sideways, if the umbilical cord is being severely compressed, or if there's a problem with the placenta. In Hollywood, you might also need a cesarean if your baby is an alien with horns on its head.
If we don't deliver the baby now, its ridges could perforate the uterus and cause internal bleeding. Kes, prepare for a fetal transport. I've locked onto the baby's coordinates. We're ready to begin. Initiating umbilical separation, energizing. Congratulations, Ensign. It's a girl.
The cesarean rate in the United States in 1965 was less than 5%. Now, for various sociological, medical, economic, and legal reasons, it's 31% and climbing. Television reflects and perhaps reinforces our increasingly casual attitude toward major abdominal surgery.
Despite having the drip for 2 hours, she's had a good trial of labor, but the head is still extremely high. It's too high to deliver from below.
So it's a C-section?
It's a C-section, yeah.
In extreme reaction to the medicalization of birth, there are a few advocates of unassisted birth, birth with no medical support at all. It's hard to find a midwife or doctor who believes that unassisted birth is risk-free, but it does serve the social purpose of reminding mothers that birth is something most humans can do on their own.
Acuéstame, acuéstame.
Ay, bebé. Bebé. Ay, bebé. Ay, perdón. Ay, bebé. Es una niña. Es una niña. Ah, bebé.
Are these my only choices? An unnecessary cesarean? Or an orgasm in a hot tub?
These are real women giving birth. There's less diversity in Hollywood, where the average laboring woman is married, white, able-bodied, heterosexual, slender, and about 30.
Push, one, two, three.
The mass media do all sorts of things to sell advertising space, theater tickets, magazine subscriptions. The media exploit our anxieties about birth. Anything to keep us tuned in till the next commercial.
5, 7, 9.
Oh, blah!
Meanwhile, natural birth filmmakers counter with a different emphasis.
Seeing a new life coming into the world is an exciting thing. Those births that you see on TV, mostly that doesn't happen. There was no screaming, no squealing, well, except for me and my little sisters.
And I expected to be like grossed out or something, but it wasn't. It was just beautiful, and I was like, wow, that is, it's my little brother.
The mass media routinely exaggerate fear and danger.
A flood forces a young woman to deliver her baby in a tree. Here on a classroom floor, a lot could go wrong. Infection, lack of oxygen to the baby, uncontrolled bleeding.
Endless weeks of waiting have all come down to this. Every Thursday at 10, lives hang in the balance.
We could lose this baby.
Natural birth filmmakers emphasize calm and confidence.
The genius of her body is designed to give birth with ease and grace. In our soft, warm hands, we're holding the keys to our future. Natural birth is a powerful initiation, a rite of passage for all involved. Within the sacred act of birth lies a pathway to the pure potentiality of life. This is birth as nature knows it. This is birth as we know it.
Hollywood features women lying down, being told what to do.
All right, went through this, the last girl training. I got my disposable obstetrical kit here. No problem. Okay, I got everything I need in this kit here. Push. Come on, push. 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 I can see the head. I can see the head. Come on, push. Push. Come on. All right, deliver the head. Quarter turn to the left. Come on, body's coming out. Come on, one more push. Come on, yes, yeah! Okay, I got him.
Meanwhile, natural birth films feature women working with gravity and moving freely. Hollywood shows a mad rush to the hospital.
Ricky, this is it.
Desperate for the ambulance to arrive. They had no way of knowing the driver was lost.
What is it?
I think
shit!
What?
Oh,
what?
I cut my
My hand.
Oh, wow, that's bad.
Samuel?
Hang on, honey. This is quite serious.
Samuel?
That is going to need stitches. Seriously.
Samuel?
What?
My water broke.
Well, we'll get you another.
No, this my water broke.
This water broke?
Yeah.
That means it's time, doesn't
that's
it?
That's right. It's time.
Well, then we got to go to the hospital.
Right. Right.
Well, go, 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 go.
Wait. Wait for me.
So labor goes fast on screen, even for a first-time mother. It has to be fast. A sitcom is only 22 minutes long.
Where is Dr. Green?
Occasionally, when the mad rush fails, TV gives us car birth.
Wait a minute, Robert. Which way are you going? This is the LIE. I said to take the bridge.
Look, I know what I'm doing.
What? Why?
Well, there seems to be a little traffic.
Meanwhile, educational films show us how labor is, in fact, often very, very slow. Hollywood frames the hard work of birth as pain that nobody wants.
Have the baby. There we go. One little push.
Okay.
Here's your baby.
Pain-free childbirth was unthinkable a century ago. Today, it is what most moms have come to expect.
That's just what you.
And it is possible through modern anesthesia.
Most people are very happy to see their anesthesiologist.
The second I found out I was pregnant, people would say, are you going to have an epidural? And I'm like, absolutely.
In Hollywood, an empowered woman is a woman with an epidural.
Prepare number two.
Why an epidural?
You want natural child.
No, I want drugs, Larry, I want drugs! Yes. Knock me out! Knock me out!
Yes, doctor.
Call the anesthesiologist. This woman needs an enema.
An enema?
Enema?
Enema!
No, she needs a pedicure.
Pedicure? Ain't no goddamn beauty parlor.
Epitaph.
She's not dead, you moron!
Epidermis? What is it, Epilady?
Epidural, asshole!
That's it! Yes! That's what I mean.
Well, come
I mean
on,
an epidural.
Epidural!
I always get those confused. Enema, pedicure, epidermal. I should buy myself a clitoris.
You need a thesaurus is what you need.
Here's another pop culture commentary on epidural anesthesia.
I'm not having any pain. I had an epidural. See?
But in this documentary, women look at pain differently.
Okay. You get the highest oxytocin rush you'll ever have in your life when you give birth naturally. You will go into an altered state of consciousness and be in a kind of a state of, yes, there's bliss, and yes, there's pain, and it's all tied up together, and you cannot have the bliss without the pain. And it's the intangible essence of that we have so much trouble conveying to women.
So exciting. It was such an adventure. Like, it was the most adventurous day I've ever had in my life.
I mean, it's crazy to say. It's a day where you're going through so much pain and so much emotion. It was one of those days where you know you're alive.
We've been looking at some of the common media themes: fear, danger, speed, pain. But perhaps the most common theme in Hollywood birth scenes, oddly enough, is this. It's about the man. Sometimes he's the victim of female violence against men.
Honey, I'm so proud of you and I love you so much.
I hate you! You did this to me, you miserable piece of dick brain, horseshit, slime-sucking son of a whore bitch!
That's perfect, sweetheart. I got it all on film. The kids are gonna love it. Maybe I'll put it in a...
I will remember that vasectomy we talked about. I don't like it right now. You're a woman. You gotta help me. Smother me with the pillow. Do it for sisterhood. Do it for Betty for Dan. Kill me now.
She's going to blow.
I hate you, Paul Murray!
I love you too.
Men used to get off easy.
Will you please take Mrs. Ricardo to room 354? Oh, you will have to say goodbye to your wife down here. You're not allowed upstairs.
Now they're expected to show up for labor.
You sure this is the fastest way to the maternity ward?
Sometimes, men are fighting with each other about control over the birth.
Hey, all right. Now look, her sister is staying. You want me to leave, you're going to have to physically throw me out of the room.
You can't be serious.
Go ahead and try it. You're going to be glad you're already in a hospital.
Okay, fine. I don't have time to argue. Look, just put on a gown and get out of my way, all right?
Quite a man you got.
Yeah, he's my protector.
You're starting to tear, so I'm going to have to cut you. Holy God.
Homer, that's... Oh!
Step aside. I'll deliver this baby.
Why don't you let me handle it, Homer?
Oh, Kelly's boy, eh?
Homer, for God's sakes, let him deliver the baby.
Sometimes the man avoids all this by giving birth himself.
All right. Push here. Ready? Push. 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 Your baby, Alex.
We don't know why Arnold is pushing during a cesarean, but for that matter, we don't know where he got his uterus. In natural birth films, many partners share in the mother's transformation. And then we have reality shows.
Doctors here choose from a range of labor interventions for their patients. With her husband by her side, Lee undergoes her second and probably her last C-section. Fred is determined to get every minute on tape. On this highly managed labor and delivery floor, doctors often induce labor to speed up the birthing process.
So we're going to proceed with the induction.
She did it. Oh, good. I'm excited.
She had pitocin even if she's progressing.
She'll still take the pitocin if she's progressing. It augments her labor. It's an additive thing.
2/3 of all pregnant women watch these reality shows, but only 1/4 of all pregnant women go to childbirth classes. If natural childbirth does appear in Hollywood, it's typically not just a regular woman having a baby. It's an extraterrestrial, or it's an eccentric mother in an exotic location, or it's a 15th century indigenous woman hiding from bad guys in a flooded cave with a toddler on her shoulders. Natural birth with a betazoid alien with excellent lipstick.
Now, do you want something for the pain? It will in no way diminish the experience.
I have felt no pain.
None?
None at all.
The baby's doing wonderful, Troy. Breathe slowly. You're doing great. Stay calm. That's it. There it is. I've got him. You can relax.
Here's an exotic location.
Some mothers dream of giving birth in water with the help of dolphins. Sarah Sensi and six other pregnant women traveled from England to Israel to make that dream a reality. Sarah was calmed by the dolphin's presence.
It was a really lovely, comforting sound hearing them talking to each other underwater.
Here's an extremely exotic location.
Roe found an ancient rock quarry, but this remote setting had one drawback. If complications set in, getting Mika to a hospital would be a time-consuming challenge.
It turned out to be an ideal birthing place, but virtually inaccessible.
Their solution was Dr. Roger Leachy, a medical doctor practicing as a midwife.
From an orthodox medical perspective, what we did could be labeled as reckless.
So, medical intervention is portrayed as normal, and natural birth is portrayed as exotic. We're also seeing an increasingly obsessive fascination with celebrity moms. Bellies and babies are now fashion accessories.
Meet these amazing models who combine motherhood with livelihood and still manage to look oh so good.
Mia's belly is so beautiful. It's sexy.
Tabloids offer an unrealistic and idealized version of motherhood. These mamas look pretty empowered, but behind the scenes there's an army of nannies, personal trainers, private chefs, and Photoshop technicians. Mere mortal moms in the checkout line might feel a little bit inadequate, but they can also enjoy the fact that no matter how bad a day they might have had, Brittany's was probably worse. The mass media tell us that one reason for the skyrocketing cesarean rate is that women themselves are demanding it. On TV, it looks like lots of women prefer cesarean birth to something called the other.
Lee is among a growing trend of women choosing to have a cesarean delivery. This is Lee's second cesarean, which could complicate the procedure.
I'm okay with it, because it's the known. I know what to expect with it versus the other.
I'm for a nice clean cut rather than a bunch of tears. Thank you very much.
But it's unclear whether this represents a real trend. In a recent study, 1,600 new mothers were surveyed, and only one had requested a cesarean. Meanwhile, on the other end of the cultural spectrum, some celebrities are choosing to give birth at home with qualified midwives.
You know, at one point she said, reach down and pull out your baby. And I did. It's just everything to me.
Media literacy is the skill of viewing the media critically. Pregnant audiences in particular need to be very discerning so their decisions and their bodies aren't compromised by excessive fear. For example, when a scary narrator manipulates viewers like this.
At 39 weeks pregnant and at the age of 45, Stephanie is considered an advanced maternal age mother and could face related complications, including hypertension, high blood pressure, or a baby born with Down syndrome.
A savvy viewer knows that it could just as well have been presented like this.
The genius of her body is designed to give birth with ease and grace. In our soft, warm hands, we're holding the keys to our future.
Here are two of the most unhelpful TV shows I've encountered. The first is a wildly unrealistic episode of ER, directed by Quentin Tarantino, in which a very nice mother-to-be dies after a highly improbable series of medical mistakes. Sometimes, activists try to encourage TV producers to help create a healthier cultural environment. But don't hold your breath. This episode of ER won an Emmy. Unhelpful show number 2 oversimplifies the decision to use epidural anesthesia, which involves injecting drugs into the area around the spinal cord.
Carol.
What?
Why is it so important for you to have this baby without pain medication?
Because I want to be present for every moment of this baby's birth.
Oh. You're gonna be present, I can guarantee that. You'll be real present. But honey, you seem to be under the impression that you need to be in agony.
Yeah, well, isn't it better for the baby if I don't take anything?
Not necessarily. If you're exhausted and in a lot of pain, that's not good for the baby when it comes time to deliver.
Oh, well, I really wanted to have this baby naturally.
Carol, the only way this baby will not be born naturally is if it comes out your nose.
Well, maybe it wouldn't hurt if I took a little something for the pain.
Absolutely not. So we'll give you an epidural. Mm-hmm. It's perfectly safe for you, and it won't hurt the baby one bit.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. Epidurals can be helpful, and in the U.S., 76% of laboring women are choosing them. But it should be an informed decision, because they also carry risks. In any case, epidurals are more than just a little something.
How we doing, honey?
Oh, I'm okay. I decided I'll just take a little something for the pain.
Does somebody want drugs in here?
Oh, yeah, but you better hook her up first, okay?
Don't worry. In a few minutes, you won't feel a thing.
Oh, God bless you.
And now for something completely different. A critique of industrialized delivery.
Hello, now don't you worry. We'll soon have you cured. Leave it all to us, you'll never know what hit you. Goodbye, goodbye. Drips up, injections.
Can I put the tube in the baby's head?
Only if I can do the episiotomy.
Okay. Okay.
And our legs up. Come in. Come on in, all of you. That's it, jolly good. Come on, come on. Spread around there. Who are you?
I'm the husband.
I'm sorry. Only people involved are allowed in here. All right.
What do I do?
Yes?
What do I do?
Nothing, dear. You're not qualified. Here it comes. And frightening. Here. And the rough toes. Show it to the mother. That's enough. Right, sedate her, number the child, measure it, blood type it, and isolate it.
Natural childbirth advocates are concerned that we might be losing something important.
It's the sensation of our bodies opening. It's the sensation that comes with the profound changes that happen in our lives as we come into motherhood.
Natural birth is a loving way to come into the world. It's a very gentle way. It's very sweet. There's a lot of smiles. There's a lot of laughter. There's a lot of quiet. There's a deep sense of satisfaction. There's a deep sense of pride.
It's perfect. It's the one perfect experience I think I'll ever have in my life. And things will come close. I'll have great experiences. I own this.
You know, if we looked at every birth as a miracle and a celebration and brought each child into the world that way, I think we would value life. I do really think that on a very deep level, if we valued life that way, that it would change who we are as a society.
Every once in a while, Hollywood shows a simple birth without a lot of added drama.
I was lucky and I had Carol as my midwife during my labor. And she is a very, very soft and kind person. And she just soothes you just being around you. Sherry is a different person than Carol. And I'm happy that I had Carol during my labor, but Sherry during my delivery, because they are just a great combination for this kind of thing, because Sherry is very proactive. She's push, don't whine, you're wasting your energy on this whining. It's totally worth it, but it was painful. I can't lie about that. So, but it's great, it's worth it.
Oh my God, there it is. It's Crowning.
Crowning. Shelly, listen to me. Try to keep the baby just where it is, okay? Remember your technique? Okay, breathe, relax.
It's crowning.
One big push, come on. Ed.
Doctor, Ed, I gotta push. Can I push?
Can you push? Push.
I'm pushing.
Breathe.
Wait for me, hold on.
All right, here we go.
Coming?
Oh my God, it's coming.
It's coming.
One big push, come on.
All right. Look who's here.
It's a girl.
Oh my God, I've got a little girl. Oh, Shelly, we've got a little girl.
We sure do. She's got a good set of bagpipes on her, too.
Joel, is that the right color? Is she supposed to be blue?
Trust me, Holly, she is perfect. She is absolutely beautiful.
That scene remains one of the most joyful, woman-centric, community-centric birth scenes ever presented in fictional TV. So what if they forgot the umbilical cord? Here's a childbirth education film that shows a lovingly supported birth in a hospital. Plus, the baby's father is endearing.
That's away and again. Come right back.
When you get to the point where you see the head crowning, you start to feel some relief.
Good. Real good.
And again.
I started at that point to just realize, okay, I'm coming to the end of this and she's coming out.
Good.
Good job. And again.
Good.
Push. Excellent.
Push.
Very
good.
That's the way. Just a gentle push. Here she comes. Here's the girl.
She's
looking at her mommy.
Oh, look at her dad. I was real euphoric during that time when she came out.
I felt a strong bond with Aaliyah immediately. Being able to see her and hold her was very exciting, and I think that just really solidified this strong ongoing relationship.
I felt a strong bonding with Jeff going through that process. I did some spiritual bonding with him, which connects the three of you.
Here's a film that shows a water birth with qualified midwives at home. Plus, the father and the kids are endearing.
And I realized very soon that when I was walking towards my husband, the sensation in my womb felt as if the sun wanted to burst out of my belly. And if I looked at him, it was very clear, as if it was our love that was swollen inside my belly and that was just wanting to burst out. He was walking back and I was walking forward just looking at him, and we walked together. And I think that was his way of making sure it only felt like love bursting out and not so much like pain. I just went deep, deep inside of me, and I could see and feel everything inside, how it was opening and moving down. And then she turned, and I could feel her ears and her nose. And I realized this is really a person. I knew I was going to have a child, but to actually feel her with my hands and touch her cheeks and her nose and her little ears as she was still inside me was fantastic. And with four hands, we just brought her up. I saw her face, I realized that's her, of course, that's who I was expecting, that's my baby. And very, very soon after she was out, my son, who was already in the nude, jumped in the tub, and so we were together, and the younger one who was asleep, we asked for him to be brought, and he jumped in too, and so we were, the five of us, a new family. Ready to welcome her, and I think for them, they adore her. They saw her being born. They saw her the first minute she was out. That's their baby, just as much as she's our baby.
In the time it's taken you to watch this film, 15,000 babies have been born on planet Earth. Some of them are healthy, some are suffering. Some of them are being warmly welcomed, some will struggle to get what they need. Each is a real person. Each has a story worth telling. Each is a complete human being who has just emerged from a hard-working mother. In the real world, birth is astonishing and dramatic all by itself.
The day we've waited on has arrived. I'm giving you all the support that I can provide. You have a reservoir of strength flowing deep inside. Your bravery fills me with tremendous pride. I'm your man, by your side I'll always stand. And I wanna hold your hand. Being here's worth more than 100 grand. In fact, priceless. Love manifest. Relax your mind, let your conscience be free. How it is how it's supposed to be. So relax your mind, let your body be free. You got this, you got this. So relax your mind, let your conscience be free. How it is how it's supposed to be. Relax your mind, let your body be free. You got this, you got this. Know there's so much beauty coursing through the pain, and know there's so much love coursing through our veins. The way you look into my eyes helps to keep me sane. I'm here in the moment trying to do the same. As you bring creation like fresh falling rain, my soul's crops grow when I think of your name. You're loving and creative just like Mama Earth. So these words are dedicated to you giving birth to what will be our beautiful child, into a world that's sometimes troubling and wild. We don't know whether it's a boy or a girl, but we know it's the most beautiful this thing in this world. We can't wait to look into your eyes and hold you, educate and raise you to rise and help mold you into a force of love. You're gonna take flight above like the wings of a dove. From the day when those two lines first appeared, we've patiently waited for you to be here. And to my loving wife, who I hold so dear, the next stage of this journey is oh so near. So listen to these words that I sing. You gotta lose yourself in something, whether emotional, spiritual, or visual. The more strain in your brain, the more pain in your physical. Relax your mind, let your conscience be free. How it is how it's supposed to be. So relax your mind, let your body be free. You got this, you got this. So relax your mind, let your conscience be free. How it is how it's supposed to be. Relax your mind, let your body be free. You got this, you got this. So this last verse goes to our soon born baby. Free creatively like the way you were made. In your arrival I feel the presence of light. Your soul and body born from the essence of life. For the last 40 weeks your mom held you day and night. We promise forever to hold you in the light.
We as a species have a pretty poor track record recently with the way we bring in new people into this world. Around the world, in third world countries especially, the C-section rates are up to 80, 90, 95% in South Africa and Brazil. Oh. It's staggering, it's sad, because it has vast implications on the quality of our life. It's not just about birth. Birth was never just about birth, because the way we're born defines the way we live, really. But that includes not only the birth itself, also the way we were gestated throughout 9 months of pregnancy, also the way we were conceived. It turns out that everything that we experience from the moment that our soul took that commitment and willingness of embodying in this three-dimensional reality, which is sometimes it's few months before the pregnancy, before the conception, everything that happens with parents affects the way this person will live, experience owning the body. So that's how our civilization right now, in the state that it is now, is reflecting our birthing practices.
Let's do it again. What would your message be to women around the world?
Well, my message to women around the world is we can do it. And even more so, we are the ones who can. We are the ones we've been waiting for. It's not up to our government to give us permission to be powerful. It's not up to our doctors to empower us and give us permission to claim our birthright. It's not up to anybody else. It's up to each woman to wake up and live her life. It's really that basic, that intimate. It's up to each woman to take her life into her own hands and live it. Mm-hmm. Live it to her full potential, fully engaged in her own life, in life of her children, in creating those children.
And really trust yourself and be willing to actually investigate the veneers that we've accumulated in this life that keep us from accessing our most intrinsic nature, which is naturally ecstatic. And, you know, if one can actually really explore what's holding us back and be willing to look it straight in the face and move to the other side, we can be living an entirely new life that is really aligned with what we really want to be creating.
What would your message be to women around the world?
We can do it. And the time is now. That is my message, that nobody is out there to do it for us. We cannot wait for the government to give us permission, for doctors to give us permission. They're too invested in keeping the status quo. There is so much resources and emotional, spiritual, religious, economical, social forces are involved in keeping women out of their power.
How did conscious birth into being, how did that become your passion in this lifetime for you?
Well, I met with Igor Cherkovsky in 82, and I met with him as a foreign force to come and help him, and he was really struggling in being heard. So my very dear friend asked me to help, and I met with him just to see if it's some crazy person, you know, there's a lot of crazy ideas out there before I bring it to the meeting of our team. And it was a 4-hour download. In 4 hours, he told me everything he knows about connection between formative period and how we live. In 82, he had it completely down. Without reading anything, he's not a mental person. He doesn't really have time or room in his head for books. He is this crazy healer, a really large presence, but very, very intense. And what he was telling me was not read. It was his understanding of the way life works. And on top of it, nothing was written about it in Russian at that time. There was this Iron Curtain at that time, and we didn't even have the concept of prenatal psychology, of that there is already some things in writing in America, that there was already Dr. David Chamberlain's books out at that time, but not in Russia. It was all unheard of. So in 4 hours, he completely gave me a transmission of the impact the birth has on the way we live. And I was sitting there stricken with the whole understanding, oh my God, all these games that we're doing, it's just, you know, to fix the problems, to make us more comfortable with that quality of living, to deal with complications that we cause because we're just not born well. If we are born well, we don't create that level of chaos. We don't have that level of aggression and fear-based mentality. Babies that are born well are kind. They're compassionate. They are absolutely don't have a need to inflict pain on their friends, on their neighbors, on themselves. They don't have self-destructive patterns in their behaviors. They don't come here for pain. They come here to play, to enjoy being in the body. There is no accident that every cell on our skin has a pleasure receptacle. We are wired for good life.